Hello everyone. In this video, I want to discuss about the latest cellular technology, that is 5th generation cellular technology. Many rumors about this technology as it is using very high frequencies. So before getting into how the 5G conventional technique works, we have to think about the previous generations, what they have used, because every generations are using certain part of the frequencies in an electromagnetic wave for their operations. So in 1G technology, they are using 850 or like nearly 1600 megahertz of frequency for their operation. And in second and third generations, combine these together and they operated nearly at 2.1 or 2.5 gigahertz of frequencies. But now, what is happening? The fifth generation's internet, it is combining both of the 4G, 3G, 2G, everything of the previous generations, and they are operating in ultra wide band frequencies. What is the meaning of ultra wide band frequency? Well, it is operated near 28 gigahertz or 39 gigahertz. It is very very high frequency because it is operated in the millimeter wave. And another question arises: does it pose danger to the organisms and human beings? Well, there is another part of the concept in electromagnetic radiation. As we all know, electromagnetic radiation consists of radio waves, microwaves, infrared, visible light, ultraviolet, X-rays and gamma rays. So as we move from radio waves to gamma rays, the frequency increases, our wavelength decreases. So this 5G technology uses the electromagnetic spectrum which is just below the microwave. That means it is nearly operated in the gigahertz but not exceeds that limit. And we have known that some of the part of the electromagnetic wave are ionizing and some part of the electromagnetic wave are not ionizing. What is the meaning of ionizing and non-ionizing? Well, the radiation such as ultraviolet, X-rays and gamma rays, when passed through the body, human body, they can alter the DNA and cause mutations and another dangers. So when we are using TVs and laptops and Wi-Fi, everything operates in radio wave part of the electromagnetic spectrum. And fortunately, radio wave is not an ionizing radiation. That means even though we are immersed in the ocean of electromagnetic waves of radio waves, there is no danger because they can't pass through the body. But you might think that the 5G operates in higher frequency, they might have the capacity of entering into the body, but there is a international committee which decides the amount of the radiations when enter into the body, and the effect of that radiation to the body is all calculated and it is under the safe limit. So there is no possibility of threat to the humans or any kind of animals because of this fifth generation internet. And this is also certified by the WHO along with the committee which decides the amount of radiations that may cause the danger to the human body. So in the end, what we can conclude? So using the fifth generation internet is very good for downloading because it enhances the rate of download and upload speed, everything will be increased. But as long as we are not hiding the truth, penetrating the human minds into the undisturbed part of the electromagnetic mystery, we cannot know what will happen in the future. But anyway, we are all curious to use the fifth generation internet, and let us hope for the best. Thank you.